Namaste children, in this session number 42, we are going to discuss brain teasers, first main A question, B question and in second main we are going to solve two sub questions children. Children, let us start with the first main A question, take the correct option. First question, A question is 0.225 expressed as a rational number is. Here 0.225 is equal to 225 divided by 1000, which is equal to, we are going to divide with 5 table. 5 2s are 10, 2 zeros as it is, 5 4s are 20, 2 is left 25, 5 5s are 25, 45 by 200, which is equal to, again divide by 5 table. 5 9s are 45, 5 4s are 20, 1 0 as it is. So the simplest form is 9 by 40. So the answer is 9 by 40 children. In these type of questions, we have to solve and then find the correct answer. Next is question number B. A rational number P by Q can be expressed as a terminating decimal if Q has no prime factor other than 2 and 3, 2 and 5, 3 and 5, 2, 3, 5. So, to find out whether the given rational number can be expressed as a terminating decimal, it should have no prime factor other than 2 and 5. Question number C, minus 7, 8 by 100 expressed as a decimal number is. Here is minus 7, 8 by 100. We have to convert this mixed number into improper rational number. 100 sevens are 700. 700 plus 8, 708 divided by 100, negative sign as it is. Now 708 divided by 100 is equal to minus, because in the denominator we have two zeros followed by one. So write the numerator 708, count two digits from the right side, 1, 2, and keep a decimal point. Therefore, answer is minus 7.08. So, the answer is fourth one, minus 7.08. Next is question number D, 4.01325 bar for 25 is equal to. Here, in this decimal number, only 25 has to be repeated. So, we have to find out in these four options where is 25 repeated children. Here you can observe 4.0132, 3 is one time, then 25 is recurring. So the answer is first one. Next is question number E. The quotient when 0.00639 is divided by 0.213 is. Here we have 0.00639 divided by 0.213. To make the numerator whole number, we have to shift the decimal point to the right side. So how many digits you have to shift? Children, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And in the denominator, we have to shift 1, 2, 3. Since we shift the decimal point in the to the right side, we have to divide by number of zeros followed by 1. How many number of zeros should be followed by 1 is decided by the number of digits after the decimal point. So here into 1000 in the numerator and 1 lakh in the denominator. 3 zeros get cancelled. You are left with 639 divided by 213 into 100 in the denominator. Now you should know the table. 213 ones are, 213 threes are. 3 by 100 is equal to 0.03. So the answer is third one, 0.03. Children, next you have question number B. Answer the following questions. Without actual division, determine if minus 28 by 250 is terminating or non-terminating decimal number. -200 and 250. In the denominator, we have to know what is the prime factor we get by prime factorization method. Because it is not in the simplest form, you can cancel it by 2 table. 2 14s are 2 125s are. -14 by 125. Here in the denominator you have 125. We know after prime factorization we get 5 into 5 into 5. 5 5s are 25. 25 5s are 125. So 125 can be written as 5 into 5 into 5. Therefore, the prime factor should be either 2 or 5. Yet it is only 5. Therefore, the given rational number is will have terminating decimal. Next is question number B. Convert -113 divided by 7 to decimal. Here, let us take the question -113 by 7. We have to divide by long division method. 7 table, 7 is the divisor. So 7 ones are 7. 11 minus 7 is 4. Next number is 3. 7 6 are 42. Subtract 1 is left. 1 is less than 7. Therefore, take the decimal point. We can take 1, 0. Now 7 ones are 7. 3 is the remainder. Since we have taken decimal point, you can borrow the 0. 7 4s are 28. 2 is the remainder. Again we borrow the 0. 7 2s are 14. 6 is the remainder. Borrow the 0. 7 8s are 56. Subtract, you get 4. You have to observe whether the remainder is repeated or not. Then you have one more 0. 7 5s are 35. Remainder is 5. One more 0 you borrow. 7 7s are 49. Subtract, you get 1. You can observe here is the step repeated. Therefore, the answer is 6.142857, which this number is recurring. Since it is recurring from 1, so we have to put the bar for all the numbers after the decimal point. Therefore, the answer will be in negative -16.142857 bar. Next is question number C. What should be subtracted from -15.834 to get 3.476? You have to take x, let the x be subtracted. Then we have to form the statement. What has to be subtracted from this number means after from what is written should be written first. -15.834 minus x is equal to get 3.476. Now solve for x. Minus x is written in the same side. Minus this number is taken to the left right hand side. It becomes +15.834. Both are having same sign, that is plus. We have to add. You get 19.31. Minus x is equal to 19.31. Therefore x will be equal to -19.31. Next is question number D. Express 4.82 as rational number in the standard form. These type of problems we have done in the worksheets. 4.82 can be written as 482 divided by 100. Cancel with 2 table. 250s are 100. 22s are 4. 24s are 8. 21s are 2. 241 by 50 is the rational number in the standard form. Find the value of 16.016 divided by 0.4. Let us write it in the rational number. Then we have to remove the decimal point. In the denominator you have one digit after the decimal point. So 0.4 is written as 4 by 10. Since 4 is in the denominator, we write 4 by 10. 16.016 is written as 16,016 divided by 1000. 1010 get cancelled. And 4 table, we are going to divide. 4 ones are 4. 4 4s are 16, 0 as it is, 1 is less than 4, so take one more 0. Now you have 16, 4 4s are 16. 4004 divided by 100 can be written as 40.04. Children, next we have question number 2. Convert the following rational number into decimals. Here we are given the rational numbers. We have to convert them into decimal number by long division method. 3 is the divisor. 3 8s are 24. 25 minus 24 is 1. Take the next number 9. 3 6 are 18. 19 minus 18 is 1. Now 1 is less than 3. Therefore, we take the decimal point. Next one, we borrow 1 0. 3 3s are 9. Again, 1 is repeated. Here, 3 is recurring, children. Therefore, the answer is 86.3 bar. Next is question number 2. 19,256 divided by 11. 11 is the divisor. So 11 1s are 11, 19 minus 11 is 8, next number is 2. 11 7s are 77, 82 minus 77 is 5, next number is 5. 11 5s are 55, next number is 6. 11 5s are 55 again. Then we have decimal point. Children, here you have to observe the remainder is 0. Still we have the next number. To take this next number, first we have to take one 0, children. Then we will take down 6, number 6. Then again you have to observe 6 is less than 11. Therefore we have to take decimal point. Then we will borrow one 0. Now 11 5s are 55. 60 minus 55 is 5. We take one more 0. 11 4s are 44. 50 minus 44 is 6. One more 0. 11 5s are 55. Here remainder is 5, which is repeated. Therefore, the answer is 175.54 bar. 54 is recurring. Children, in this way we have finished brain teasers first main A question, B question, and in second question two problems we have solved in this session, children. Hope you have understood well. Thank you, children.